topic is special education in Greece, challenges and prospects. First of all, I would like to say that I work in primary school in Greece, and whatever I'm gonna say, it's a first-hand experience. It's my experience throughout the whole pandemic, last year, but especially this very academic year. And as you will see, some applications, they're all the formal applications that the Greek government provides us and proposes for our work. So starting with lockdown sessions, the first period, this academic season, 2020-21 in Greece, it was from November 16th till December 24th, so 1 month length. The second period was March 12th till May 10th. So it's about 2 months, 1.5 months, because it was Easter vacation inside as well. So the tools that we used for education in Greece was the synchronous tools of a WebEx platform that the Greek government provided to us. We were obliged to use WebEx. And asynchronous tools like e-class, e-me, and e-mail.
Is this working?
I'm keeping going. You see the synchronous and asynchronous tools that we used. This is the typical Greek primary school program. When we were at school, as you see in the yellow places, the obligatory school hours for a child. And in the blue place, it's the hours for children whose parents have to work later. So a child, a student in primary school, was about 5 hours per day obligatory in a school. And when we went online, it was only 3 hours, as you see. About teachers, when working at school, we have to teach 24 hours per week. When we went online, it was 20 to 24 hours per week. It was depending on the years of service of every teacher. So the student that I deal with this year, it's a student with ADHD, ADD, and special learning difficulties like dyslexia, for example. Asynchronous tools that were used, it's like I said before, e-class, e-me, and the school email. And so through these tools, I provided individual homework, PDF or Word, some presentations that they were stored, and any student could any time he liked to open and watch this presentation. Interactive worksheets, a lot of mind maps, some educational games, of course, especially about mathematics, and some online stories. For example, the Story Jumper is a great application that we were taught to use, and we have some great results. The feedback, it was through messages on asynchronous platforms like eClass or eMe, through email, rarely through Viber. We used this as well because some parents didn't know to use the platforms. And it was done mostly using the application of Pixlr. It's a free application. Most parents were sending me the homework of their children on JPG, you know, photos. So Pixlr is a very easy and fast way to correct every homework and give some motivation, some feedback with some stickers and some draws that provides to you. So going on the synchronous tools, WebEx. I am a teacher of special education, so I don't teach a regular, typical student. And through WebEx, my function was much, much more difficult. So in the first way, I was using my digital live classroom. I was a host and presenter. I had 1, 2, or 3 kids at the most.
and we were having some interactive lesson. In a second way, I was in a colleague's, in another teacher's digital classroom,
and I was helping students through the chat box as a co-host. And the third way that I could use WebEx, it was again in a colleague's digital classroom, forming breakout sessions. I was a co-host and presenter as well. From my personal experience, the one that worked better, it was the third option. I was inside another class with another colleague, and when I had to, I was forming the breakout session, and I was taking my student to another classroom, to another room, so as to explain him something that it was difficult for him. So the pros, it's that writing on Word, on notepads, digital, are very helpful for students with dyslexia. They help them in spelling. So it provides general digital and technological literacy to kids and to parents as well. It was new and funny challenge for kids, especially the first weeks. And of course, the most positive, like I said at the beginning, it was that the process of education, it was not stopped. We kept some contact. So let's go to the cons, which are much more. First of all, functional. In Greece, internet lines are very slow, or some kids, some families, they don't have hardware problems. Our PCs, laptops are old, or some families they didn't have at all, or printer. Many students were trying to connect through smartphones. For example, I had a student suffering from dyslexia who was attending the whole lockdown period, about 3 months in total, through a smartphone with a broken screen. So you can just make it in your mind, I don't know, in your mind, a child, 9 years old with dyslexia, and having the whole lesson through a smartphone with a broken screen. I don't know what else to say. Students and parents actually were digital illiterate, as I said before. All teachers, we had some serious problems because actually some of them, they didn't even know how to start a PC. Also, the parents working hours, as I'm gonna show after, the online lessons were about to held 2 in the afternoon till 5 in the afternoon. So it was working, it was time that parents, some parents had to work. So it was very difficult for people to, you know, to take care of their children. Also, you could not be sure that students attend. Some, they just, they were joining and they were somewhere else. They didn't attend at all. Primary school students, especially 6 to 9 years old, could not restrain themselves. Also, there was space problem because there are many siblings. There are 2 or 3 siblings in the same family in small houses, and they had to have lesson in different classes at the same time in one room. So imagine it was house. Parents were interfering in the process. I remember a mom saying all the time, come on, pick up your hand. You know the answer, say it. While the child, the student didn't want to move on. And the students complained about not listening, not watching, being bored. It's the usual, I think, like in other countries. So let's go to socio-psychological and health problems. First of all, it's in desocialization. Kids got stuck on a PC screen. Kids, they are already were on PC gaming before COVID-19. Now, actually, they had no real life. They spent all the day in front of a PC screen. Also, there were some difficulties for students with ADHD or ADD or even with dyslexia, as they couldn't focus and they couldn't sit still. They had to move all the time. So actually, they didn't attend at all. Another problem, it was that kids were sleeping late and they were waking up late. They were out of the normal routine for their age. Inappropriate school time for this age. As I said before, the synchronous lessons were about to be held from 2 in the afternoon till 5:20 in the afternoon. We experienced decreased school performance very much. Also, decreased self-esteem and confidence for kids with special skills. It wasn't like the physical presence teaching. There was absence of motivation. Some children, they developed problems in their eyes, and they had almost no physical exercise. So let's see what the government did, or actually what they didn't. As you see, the first lockdown was on March 2020, about a year ago. The second one was on November 2020, and the third on March, just 2 months ago. So educational seminars about online education, which is a duration of 8 weeks for teachers, started only this February, almost a year after the first lockdown. So it's too late for teachers to be educated for online education. I think that the government knew that we were about to keep on the e-learning, the distance learning. There are no laptops, tablets for teachers or for families. The first tablets were sent only early April, and also some vouchers for poor families to buy some tablets. In addition, not all local authorities tried to support schools, teachers, or poor families. I am lucky because in the school that I serviced this year, the local authorities stand really next to us, and they provided everything we needed, laptops, tablets, everything. But in other cities or in other schools, this wasn't the fact. And also, as a general sum up, it's that the government never listened to teachers, to our union, because we demanded this academic season to be like it never happened. And all kids in all schools, in primary, secondary schools, to rejoin next year the same class. But of course, they didn't listen to us. So, education is a way of keeping contact while a crisis appears, but also education does not substitute the process of life school education, especially about the young ages. It can work like supplementary along with normal education. In no occasion can stand itself, especially about talking, especially education about kids with special skills. It's impossible to have results without normal education. Like I said before, digital literacy of students, parents, even teachers, some of them, kids with special skills got helped in some ways, for example, in spelling. But also kids got desocialized and stuck on screens, as well as kids with special skills experienced many difficulties. They couldn't focus, they couldn't sit still, they had a big decreased performance and self-esteem confidence. Moreover, technology, we could say that is the future, so let's take it, or we can take it as an introduction in a new world, nor bad, nor good, just a new and vaguely defined world. But we have to think seriously that technology is the future. But in any case, in order to build a bright future, you have to to establish, to have some solid foundations, which actually, in my opinion, and what I experienced this year through distance learning and through distance teaching, it cannot be gained by solely online education. We need normal education, and online education, it's a good thing, a positive thing, and it can be like a supplement to the normal education, of course, in my opinion. So what do we need about tomorrow, about next day after pandemic crisis? Of course, speaking about Greece, we need some investments, more investments in the field of education. Hiring of permanent teachers. Imagine that we have around 10,000 vacancies in primary schools and 5,500 vacancies in secondary schools. A technical and technological update of schools. Literally, if you enter a Greek primary school, first you are going to laugh, and after, when you realize that this is a true image, noticing the pieces we have, you are going to just cry. It's so simple. Every student has the privilege in education, even though through internet. So we have to make sure that any child, any student, even though we are on distance learning, on distance teaching, that can have access to education. Of course, we need the training of teachers on new technologies, and we can use technology so as to promote social, gender, or racial equality. And of course, through technology, we have to support including students and not excluding from the process of education. And I think that's for me. Thank you very much for your attention. Anything you need, you can contact me in the email you see above.